Well, hello everyone. I just found this movie camera on my desk there. It's been sitting there for 2 years. I knew it was there, I just haven't used it because with Wi-Fi it's almost impossible to download the film because it's too slow. So anyway, I've cranked it up now and I'm going to make a little short movie here and then put that on Facebook and see if it works. So anyway, you guys know me, I'm Gerald McChesney, and I take all kinds of still pictures, and I used to take movie pictures with this camera, but I haven't been lately, so there's my dog, Fluffy. Of course, he has to be the star of the show, always. Hey, Fluffy, what are you doing? It's not Fluffy, it's Fuzzy. I can't even remember my own dog's name, that's pretty bad. So anyway, let me put on my shoes and we'll go outside. This is what the dog does when it wants to go outside. It starts jumping up and down on me. But normally it would jump up and down on this door, but he think it'd do now? No, of course not. Wouldn't jump on the door if it had to. Fuzzy, you want to go outside? Huh? You want to go outside or you just want to play? Okay, here we go. Nope, he's gonna hide. Okay, you stay. You stay and I'll go. Goodbye. Are you going outside or what? Come here. Come here. Jumping all around everywhere and he's outside. I think he's getting camera shy. I can imagine that, but you see, it's getting dark already. This is all the same stuff you've seen in still shots ever since I've lived here. Oh, look, he's a good doggy. I already said something to him, but of course it won't make any difference. When you're coming up to this place, it looks like some sort of a castle on the hill. When you get up here and walk around and look, it's terrible. It's as though people come here and go somewhere and buy trash, then come here and see just how much they can possibly litter. But this place, all the way around it, is just like you see here. And you can see this is outside my room. See that? Trash can's empty. But that's understandable because all the trash is over here. See? Everywhere you look. Trash, trash, and more trash. That's funny, they sometimes try to pick some up that's on the parking lot here. But anything that's not on the parking lot, see that bag in the tree there? Anything that's not on the parking lot, they just leave it. Down in that ravine must be like a trash dump. Now here's my camper. It's been sitting here now it's been sitting for 4 years. I can't use it because of my physical condition, but someday I guess I'll get mad and sell it. But I'd have to have a lot for it. It's never been used and I got $6,000 tied up in it. It's been modified a lot. Here's more of the ravine. And here's the rock road that goes up here. can see by the trees, springtime is coming. Yeah, it's sunset now. I hope this works. It hasn't been used in so long. I put new batteries in it, so I know it'll help. Here's a new laundry room that they're building. As you can see, it doesn't match the rest of the complex at all. It takes the place of A. Not even a commercial, it's a residential washer and dryer. It takes the place of that, that they have all these housekeeping people, four or six of them, something like that, uses one washer and dryer to wash all the linens and all the sheets and all the towels and all the washcloths, all of that. They're doing it all in a washer and dryer, so now they're going to make this laundry room just for housekeeping, but it's not like them to do anything good, so it wouldn't surprise me if this will end up being a nightmare of some kind too. See, I'm curious to see what they do about this. See all this grass growing up and the rocks that they're using for mulch? I don't know if they'll do anything about it or not. They may just let it all grow up in grass. And it's my theory that they're only interested in making money. They don't care anything about how anything is. The makeshift fence that you see here separates the complex I live in from the old hotel, which was a Ramada Skytop. It's supposed to reopen this month, including the club, the restaurant, the weight rooms, and the swimming pool is all supposed to open. Whether or not we're allowed to use any of that, I don't know. But as you can see, here we are back to the trash chronicles again. It's unbelievable to me. They can charge as much rent as they do here. And I pay $800 a month. And all this trash. Well, I told them, I said, you need to hire someone full time to just pick up trash. It's crazy. You can't have trash everywhere all the time. As you can see, it's actually better now than I've seen it. The wind blows everything. That's what does it. That and the fact you have nobody who regularly picks up all the trash. People that lived here had a real cute little dog, and I petted it right here one day, and the next day, I don't know if you can see it, a little pile of rocks up there. The next day I came out here and they had buried it. They didn't get it shot, so it died of parvo. So now that little pile of rocks up there is an active bacteria that'll stay strong for 4 years. And any pup that's not vaccinated will get it and die. So that's just crazy. My dog had a shot, so it's not a problem. But we've had three dogs die because the people go get them somewhere and then they don't get their shots. So anyway, it's sad. Fuzzy. Hey, talking to you. See, it's just like me. I'm always going the wrong way. I want to take your picture. Right. I sure would like you to jump up to the door here so we can go. Are you going to stay here or are you going with me? I guess you're going to stay here. I was going to go to Chef Chen and eat dinner. But I can't go there if you're going to stay here unless you want to go in the cage. You want to go in the cage? Huh? You can go in there instead of going with me. Get in there. Get in the cage. Get in the cage. All right. Finally, you jump up on the door so I can see it. All right. Here's where Fuzzy and me. Chef Chen the Fuzz. Where is he? Oh, there he is. What with the camera? What's the matter with you? Here's your big phone call. Okay, there you go. I don't know. We'll see.
Received.
Oh, no. In case y'all wonder what I'm doing, I'm at Home Depot getting a luck bamboo to give.
You have a good afternoon.
Chloris or whoever's there. Thank you for all your help. There's Home Depot. I think I'm picking it up. I don't know. It's like a Kmart. Oh, yeah. Well, that's where we were going. Chef Chen Buffet, it's in the viewer there somewhere. We see you when you fall asleep. Look at all these kids in there. Come on, Fuzzy. Let's go. Take a hike. Hey, little baby. Hey, Fuzzy. Uh-oh. If you can hear it for the train, but all the little kids are barking at the dog. I get that everywhere I go. See, it's me, and I'm here at Chef Chen.
Hiya, Pikachu!
It's movie camera,
yeah,
so.
Okay.
How are you going, Pat?
All right, it's a movie camera. You can do whatever you want.
Yeah.
What's nice?
It's a, yeah, it's a.
It's different.
No, it's the same thing.
The same thing.
This one needs company.
Okay.
You know, it looked lonely, so.
Okay.
Well, it's, as you can see, I made it here. Just pan around the room. You're going to see me in a minute right here in the mirror. There I am. There's a room they added about, I don't know, maybe a year ago now. Here's some plants from bygone days. It's still here. I assume there's still a lot. I don't know.
This is the buffet. It's not the seafood buffet of mine. So anyway, I decided to get kung pao chicken and hot sour soup for dinner from the menu, because the buffet's been up there so long now, it's probably not what I want it to be. Right in the mirror. This is the silverware that Chef Chen gave me as a gift. Very nice. The soup's arrived already. Here it is. Looks good. Looks like it always does. Well, Cloris just brought me a bowl of sweet and sour sauce, crab rangoon, and on the back side there you can see a creamer. So we're getting there. They brought my food, and it was so much food I had to move to another table. That's embarrassing. Yeah, that's all right. You gotta do what you gotta do. Wanna see a real big ugly guy? Watch this. Oh, there he is now. Yep, I promised you a big ugly guy, and I'm sure I'm not letting you down. All of this food is a combination dinner. And look at how much this kung pao chicken there is. It's crazy. Of course, you can always take it with you. But all of this for $6.95. I think that's a bargain. And well, here I am right here. Of course, I always have to get in a picture somewhere. All right. I don't think in the 4 years I've been coming here I've ever had one of those spring rolls. They're really good. Seems like mostly cabbage, but I think that's what they're supposed to be. So that's fine. It's amazing how this place stays busy. They had to open the whole other side of the room there in order to have enough to accommodate people, especially on Saturday night when it's seafood night. All my other cameras are destroyed by the lights in here. I don't know how this movie camera will do. We'll have to just wait and see. Plenty of lights.
Is it okay?
That's very nice. I like it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Here's the time
all the specifics about when they're open. Oh, I know you're going to say, oh, it's backwards. Well, here, watch this.
No, it's not. All I have to do is turn it around. This way you get a picture of a big ugly thing. See that guy there? He's sitting right here in the corner of the mirror.
Yeah, I'm really having to work now. See how much food I got left? I'm never going to make it. Look at this. Wow. I'm going to have to take this with me. It was good, though. Very good. Yeah, sure. What do you need? He's packing up my dinner so I can take it home. I ate a lot, though, but it is a lot. I appreciate you doing it for me. What is your name?
What's your name?
What is your name?
Yeah, it's Gautram. Gautram.
Gautram.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It's Chinese. I know English name.
It's what?
I know English name.
No, it's a Chinese name. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, well, everybody here seems to have an English name, too.
Yeah.
Like Lily and Debbie.
Debbie.
And Rena. And Rena has like four names. And Cloris, I'm not sure how many names she has. Well, that's all right. Yeah, you can put those in there. Sure. No, these. You can put those.
Because?
Please. Wow, this will be my breakfast and dinner tomorrow. Thank you very much for helping with that.
Check.
Oh, yeah, sure. Yeah. Okay. Well, all the food's packed up to go now. There's the receipt or the bill. Not bad. See all these people back here. Hatching. Yeah, of course.
So, how to do? Just smile.
Do what?
I mean, the American people, if they very happy to make photos, So they just smile, no to do everything. And in China, if person very happy, they do. Yeah.
Right. Well, I mean, you should do something. You got two hands and two feet that you can do other things with, right? All right. Okay. I'll see you. You'll be here Saturday?
Saturday?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, here, take a picture of me. Just point towards me.
Okay. This one?
Yeah, that's all you gotta do. No, just point it. See, I'm on there now, right?
Oh, okay.
Now, here, wait. Let me take a picture of you. Let me move it out a little bit. There, now, take a picture of me. I gotta do is point at me.
Okay. Okay.
Well, that was nice. Yeah, we're back at the car and the dog and all that. I've never stayed so long that they turned out the sign, but as you can see, I did this time.
Well, here we are back at home. This is my desk and that's my computer. That's thing there, that's my dog. And I can't download this film because there's no internet connection. So I've been waiting on that for, I don't know, a couple of hours now. So far it hasn't come back. Here's the luck bamboo that Rena gave me. It's a couple of years now, I guess I've had it. It stays in the kind of sunshine. It's not supposed to have direct sunshine all day, and then it's here with me at night. And so anyway, if we ever get the internet back, I'll finish this chapter. So, just to bring you up to speed so you know what's going on. Taurus did a wonderful job of dinner tonight, and of course most of it came home with me, and that's nice. It was very nice. All right, later.